Good morning. We are doing Uddhava Gita. This is chapter 5, the last message of Sri Krishna, verse 32 onwards. We had done till 31 where we were discussing about how everything is affected by gunas. Gunas, there are three kinds of gunas: sattva, rajas and tamas. So today we are going to proceed from there onwards and how these gunas, they affect us, and what is the diversity of the soul, how this entire thing separates out into different branches. This is what we are going to study today. We are doing Uddhava Gita chapter 5 verse 32. As long as there is rupture of the equilibrium of gunas, so long is the diversity of the soul. And so long as the diversity of the soul lasts, it is verily at the mercy of others. It seems like a little distorted. So let us try to understand what is being mentioned over here. As long as there is a rupture in the equilibrium of the gunas, there are three gunas. You know, sattva, rajas and tamas. Okay. One is related to laziness, non-performance, which is called tamas. Second one is activity based, which is rajas. And the first one, which we are talking about, is more the goodness based. Okay. So three gunas are there. There is a diversity in this. There is a separation in this. You can see there is a fine line of separation. Every human being is going through all the three. It's not that a person is only in one and not in the other two. He is there in everything. Okay. Because he keeps on thinking high and low, and sometimes laziness comes in. Sometimes, I mean, you can see from the people who join the satsangs also, isn't it? Sometimes they will not join for 3 months, 4 months, and suddenly out of the blue they will say, oh, I got to join. And then they will join, and then they are there for 4 weeks. And after that, again, you know, I've got work to do, you know, I'm very busy. I have got so many other things to do. So they disappear. And then after that, so difficult to get up in the morning and attend to all these satsangs. So then it goes away. So everybody has this mixture of gunas. The rupture means break. What is this break? Think about it when this universe was getting created. Right? When the universe was getting created, the different objects in the universe were coming in place. Right? And while the objects were forming here and there, things were happening around, sometimes some things took a brighter form, sometimes some things took a duller form. So there is a range of it. I am sure those who have seen the spectrum, you know, the light spectrum, you know, we have seen the spectrum for light. It starts in the visible and then it goes in the, you know, on this side and this side, there are two, ultraviolet and infrared, and then beyond and beyond and beyond and beyond. Nobody knows where it is going. So you will find, but can you say this is yellow, this is green? No, you can't say. Think about it. If I mix blue and yellow in a proportion of 99:1. Okay, 99 blue, one yellow. What is happening? Can you see anything? No. So now let us say 70 of blue and 30 of yellow. Do you understand what I am talking? Now if I make say 40 of yellow and then blue is reduced, and it keeps on jumping from here to there, then you will find somewhere in the middle a light green color starts appearing, you know, and then it becomes darker and darker and darker. So depending on how this mixture happens, so I hope you got the example. The example is this: where sattva ends, nobody has any clue. Where rajas starts, nobody has any clue. It is a mixture. It keeps on going round, round, round. So when a person, now even in our life, we say, you know, I am good. How good are you? Can anybody say how good are you? It's a relative term, you know, depending on every individual. You can say you are very good. It is your yardstick. You see, your yardstick is only so much. The world's yardstick might be so much. No idea how big the yardstick is. You want a particular kind of a green. Somebody else wants a particular kind of green. Nobody understands it. Okay. We have all our yardsticks. It is like we have the, you know, the yellow and the white light over here. Okay. Suppose I put all the yellow, then what happens? I put all the white. We don't know. So there is a proper mixture. And there is a diversity in between. Somewhere it diverges. Somewhere it goes here and there. So, now because of this, you will find that different objects appear. I told you green. Green is an object. It appears. Likewise, human beings appear in different diversified way, manner. And as long as this diversity is remaining in the system, we get tainted. Okay? Now, some people may say, this person is one of the worst villains of our age. Can you say that that person is the worst villain? Okay, you have not seen the world so far, okay? There will be worse and more than that. I can't say worster. He'll become worsted. Worsted is connected only to, you know, the cloth that is there. It is worse only. And if it is worst, there are gradations of worst. Can I say I have reached the top? I can't say that as well, because there will be somebody who will crack the ceiling also. Can I say I have reached the bottom, the lowermost level? Again, you can't say that you have reached the lowermost level, because there will be still lower than that. I hope you understood when I say this kind of words, all right? So where does this last? Where does this end? It doesn't end at all. How good can you be? There is no way of knowing. You have to keep on improvising better and better and better and better and better. Always. And there is no point in saying I am the bestest of the best. You understand? There is no bestest of the best also. By the way, there is no such terminology, but we use it sometimes. All right? It's like the worstest of the worst. There is no such terminology, but we use it. There is no such thing. Because it's an ongoing process, upward, downward. So, sattva guna or tamas guna, we can still keep on stretching as much as we want to. And this leads us to improvisation, you know, in this side or on this side. Alright? And that is the reason why diversity in this world is there. There is so much of diversity. We move to the next verse, verse 33. Chapter 5, verse 33 from the Uddhava Gita. So long as it is not independent, it has apprehensions from the Lord. And they who uphold the doctrine of enjoyment are smitten with grief and are stupefied. The yo-yo happens in our life so often. One day you are, you know, floating on top of the atmosphere somewhere, and the next day you are down below. Why did this happen? It is going to happen. See? There is relativity everywhere, not Einstein's relativity. This relativity existed before Einstein also. All right. So, whether you are going there or whether you are going here, suddenly you are high, suddenly you are low. And all this happens because of the fear factor. I will give you an example. The example is, suppose you have attempted your examination now and you have come first. Just think, you have come first. You are gloating, you know. I came first. How many people are willing to pull you down? I think the entire class wants to pull you down. He came first because he copied. He came first because his teacher's pet. He came first because of this reason. Everybody is going to give reasons. So, there cannot be some ultimate there first. Alright? And everything happens because of fear factor. The whole universe is afraid. those who become the prime ministers or the presidents also, they are the people who are the most afraid people, by the way. They have fear. And their fear is not unfounded. Their fear is very real. They are afraid when their chair will go away. You know how many days this impeachment hearing is going on? Okay. And it is going on and on and on. When is it going to happen? Nobody has any clue. And those who are my age will remember the Watergate scandal. Okay. The Watergate scandal was one of the worst. It went on and on and on. Nobody knew. Finally, when it happened, the fears materialized. Boom, it happened. So, here in India or anywhere in the world also. Again, those who are kings and the queens also. Sometimes they have to abdicate this throne. They have to give up their throne also. Have you not seen the Japanese emperor handing over the charge to his son? You have seen that happen. In the last 1 year itself, this is happening. It's a very, very simple process. Nobody can be up there or down there for long. Please understand this. It is not independent of the apprehensions. The fear factor, the things that make us go up and down is going to be there. How is it correlating to our life? You may ask, what is this that you are talking about? It is because of fear that everything goes haywire in our life also. Some person may say, you know, we are a very loving couple. Yeah, loving couple is again a relative term. You should know that. Okay. Right? Somebody else comes into the picture, no loving couple at all. Then hating couple. So from love to hate is a very small jump. Yesterday I gave one example, isn't it? It's the same thing. You cannot say when this changes to that or that changes to this. And this is the reason why there can be no such thing as merging and becoming one. There is nothing like a unity there. Okay? It's all going to be diffused, 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 diffused. Everything is relative, 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 relative. There is no permanency there. Did you get the point? There is no permanency. You can't stay up for a very long time. You will have to come down. And this is the reason why the gunas, they keep on doing the yo-yo within this universe and it goes up and down. We move to the next verse. Chapter 5, Uddhav Gita, verse 34. When the equilibrium of the gunas is disturbed, it is I whom sages call variously as time, soul, scripture, heavenly spheres, temperament and virtue. What is happening? See, when the equilibrium of the gunas, when this is disturbed, I told you that the gunas are there, sattva, rajas and tamas, okay? And in the universe, the disturbance comes in. The up and down happens. In your life also up and down happens. Sometimes you are on top, sometimes you are at the bottom. This yo-yo, we go on with our life every single day. It is not that, you know, one whole day I was feeling on top of the world. Sorry, you may be feeling at the beginning of the day, by the end of the day, you are half dead. Alright? You are wondering what's going to happen next. You know, that's a fear. So, did you understand what's going to happen next is called the most important factor? Time. It's time. And time is the most dangerous substance there. How much can time control? How much can time... Everything is controlled by time, isn't it? So, Krishna is telling Uddhava, I come in the form of time. I am the disruptor in your life. Okay? The yo-yo happens. I mean, you all attribute it to me only, by the way. Time is a great healer, sometimes people say. I'm sure you have heard about this. Time is a great healer. Who says time is a great healer? It's a disruptor in our life. Okay? Likewise, there are various other things which he says that soul. The soul is there. Then scriptures are there. Now, what is this scripture? Brito was telling me a story about a person. There was a person who was doing work with metal objects and one metal object went inside his eye. And he couldn't see. He was lying in the hospital bed and there he got time to think. That changed his entire life. Okay. One fine day, everything changed. And the person is now interested in finding out esoteric questions. You know, who made this earth? What is this happening to me? Blah, blah, blah. All the questions which you want to know. How did that happen? This is what happens. The scriptures also make a difference. Sometimes we read something somewhere and it makes a very, very big difference in our life. Heavenly spheres, you know, heavenly spheres, how many spheres are there? Lot of spheres are there. Okay. We have always said, you know, heavenly, no, we normally talk of going to hell. Go to hell. We say, no, go to hell. There are the worst hells also. There is Talatal, Patal and all that. All different hells are there. You can go to hell. There are different heavens also. We can go to heavens also. So these heavenly spheres are there. They are called spheres. They are called planetary systems. Up, down, both ways. Temperament and virtue. It's a part of our life, isn't it? We are temperamental people also. And all this is related to the Lord himself. He is responsible. That is what he says. People hold me responsible for all these things. He thinks that I am time, I am soul, I am this and I am that. So now we are seeing what Uddhava is going to ask him. He is going to ask him some questions. Alright. And these questions are something which we will tackle today itself. Some of them we will start with. So the question is, Uddhava said, verse number 35 says, O Lord, so long as the jiva is mixed up with the attributes that spring from the body, how can he help being bound by those attributes? And if he is not enveloped by them, how does he come to be bound? These are two separate questions. Then he says, verse 36, how do the free and the bound souls live and enjoy? By what signs can they be distinguished? What and how do they eat? How attend to other bodily functions? How do they lie or sit or go? Then he says in the last verse of this chapter, O thou, best of the knowers of answers to questions, answer me this question. My doubt is this. Is the same soul eternally bound and eternally free? Now, these are a whole load of questions. Okay? I am not going to go into the questions because the questions are very much relevant to all of us. See, the questions are very simply related to us also. O Lord, so long as the jiva is mixed up with the attributes. Just now we discussed the attributes, isn't it? Alright. Even in the attributes, the eye, ear, this is the organs, right? Then we have the mind. How much diversity is there in the mind? No idea. One day it can take you high up, second day it can take you into the gutters also, right? Then we are talking about the different aspects of intellect. Sometimes the intellect is godly, sometimes it is devilish. We don't know that also. So he says, when we are mixed up with these attributes that spring from the body is creating these attributes. When somebody, okay, who is behaving in a particular manner, please understand, you have to bear with that person because it's the attribute related to the body. That person is behaving exactly the way he's programmed the body. Did you get the point? Right? You see, if your body says, I don't like sugar, you had it, no? Diabetes. See, that is the body is creating all this. So, did you get this point? Everything, this attribute to the body itself. And how can we help being bound by those attributes? We are getting bound by those attributes, isn't it? I hate this and I like this because of our body. If I put on the AC over here, three people are going to feel cold. I will not feel cold because according to people, I have hormonal issues. So, I'm going to feel hot. So even in AC on, I may feel hot. See, did you get the point? This is hot. So you will put on the AC at 18 degrees also, still I will be feeling hot, and you will say, oh, see, look at this fellow. Did you get the point? There is always bondage in this world because of our different attributes that are there, right? And these attributes are always going to pull us down. So how is the person bound by them? How does a person believe, I have this disposition, I have that disposition, I feel cold, I feel hot? Some people have these different ways of thinking, isn't it? And they attribute it to their body. And they say, you know, I can't eat hot stuff, I have to only drink cold. Some people will say, I don't like cold because it gives me, you know, cold. Like that. So, what is the truth? Alright, some people, they take cigarettes in the toilet. Why? Because if they don't take the cigarette, they can't do what they are supposed to do. It is their mind which is bound. It's keeping them bound. I can only do this because of this reason. Why? So did you understand? How do the free and the bound souls live and enjoy? Uddhava is asking this question to Krishna. How do they enjoy? By what signs can they be distinguished? Are there distinguishing signs in them? What and how do they eat? How attend to other bodily functions? How do they lie or sit or go? So he is asking Krishna, can you please explain these things to me? Because see, is the soul, you see, we have done the soul, the issue called the soul, right from the beginning, we have been doing it. Is the soul bound or is it free? So these are questions which dog everybody, you know, how? So we have come to the end of chapter 5. We are going to move to chapter 6. These are basically questions. So that is why we will go to the next chapter. So at least you will start with some explanation, some understanding. Oh, I want to know. Just don't leave me with the questions, you know. Now let us watch our next episode, you know. Just imagine, in all those serials, you will always get, there's a question mark left behind. Ting. Please watch our next episode. And then you say, I have to wait for one whole week to understand what happened next. Okay, no. This time we will just move to the next chapter. All right. So yeah, you are not bound. You are free then. Okay. Right. We are doing Uddhava Gita, chapter 6, verse 1. This is a new chapter in which Krishna is going to explain about how a person gets bound, an individual, a person gets bound or free, and whether the soul is bound or free. He is going to answer a certain questions which Uddhava had raised in the last chapter. So chapter 6, Uddhava Gita, verse 1, the Lord said, the soul is described as bound or free from the point of the views of my gunas. But it is not so in reality. Since the gunas are creation of Maya, there is, in my opinion, neither bondage nor liberation. It's a very beautiful statement. I will read it for you again for you to let it sink in you. Krishna is giving his opinion. The Lord is telling you exactly what it means. He's saying these words. Listen to them carefully. The soul is described, everywhere it is described, as bound or free. It's either bound or free from the point of views of the gunas. But in reality, it is not like that. Since the gunas are creation of Maya, there is, in my opinion, neither bondage nor liberation. The bondage and the liberation comes to a person only because we think too much. You see, when you think about something, you are going to be bound. Right? Now this bondage appears very strangely because you start looking at the the cage. Now, when you get inside a lift, do you say, I am getting inside a cage? No, you are only bothered about reaching the higher floors or the floor below. I mean, the only idea in your mind is, this lift is going to take me to my floor, or it is going to take me, you know, whichever place that the lift is supposed to take. Did you get the point? So this understanding is, has to be there. The lift is not putting you in a bondage. Is it giving you freedom? Till you are inside that lift, you know, I'm sorry, you are not free again. Can you say in the middle, no, can I get off in the middle of the floor? No. Till you don't reach that place, you are still bound. Now, this bondage or this freedom is appearing, actually non-existent, but appears to you because of your mind. You know, many a times, people who came and asked me, should I get married? All right. Whether it is bondage or freedom, you know, ask anybody, they will say it is bondage. Okay, I am getting bound. Is it freedom? No way. No. You are getting bound over there. See, this is the way of thinking. Now, ask the sages. Ask the sages. You know what they will say? It is freedom. For them it is freedom, and for those who are married there it is bondage. How does that work? I have always quoted this story of, you know, Plato, okay, when he went to ask his master whether he should get married, and he saw, I think that was Socrates. Yes, I don't remember who, and the person's wife pours so much of, you know, dirty water on top of his head, so Plato starts running away, okay. So he says, oh, come here, what happened? Why did you were coming towards me and then you started... So he said, you know, I was going to come and ask you a question whether I should get married. Then I saw your wife doing all those things. I don't want to get married because if I get a wife like that, I'll get into trouble. So he said, don't be foolish. You should get married. Then you can become philosopher like me. It's a comedy. I think I've used this joke too many times. But the truth is that. What do you see that as? Do you see that as a bondage? Or do you see that as a freedom? You have to decide for yourself. Alright? Now, this is what Krishna is saying. He says, according to my opinion, there is neither bondage nor freedom. Both these things don't exist. But why do they exist in a person? It is believed. People start believing this. It is believed, and it is the way in which it is described. We are bound. We are bound because of the gunas. And who is gunas bound by? By Maya. See, Maya is illusory character. I want you to think about what I am saying from a dream perspective. A dream. You are meeting the worst person of your life in a dream. Okay? You are meeting the worst character in your life in your dream. And he is binding you, saying, I will not let you go. And he ties you up like that. You see, in your dream state only, you are trying to struggle. All that track, you are struggling so very hard. And then you open your eyes and you say, there's nothing like that. I am free. Did you get the point? Maya is that person. Maya is that one who makes you bound. Is it real? It is not real at all. It's not real. We assumed it is real because the dream was so vivid. You understand? Everybody's dreams are so vivid that they feel bound by it. Maya is nothing but illusion. You see, when you think of illusion, let me put it this way. A man may think, I am 25 years old. This is not the time for me to do my studies. I should not be doing my graduation. What? The person thinks like this, you know, this is not the right time. Why should I do my graduation? I'm only 25, you know. I should be earning my living today and I should be working very hard. Steven Spielberg, have you heard of him? Steven Spielberg? I'm sure Steven Spielberg, everybody has heard of. After 7 children, he went and did his graduation. 37 years after he had left school, he went and did his graduation. Can you imagine? He was in his 50s. If Steven Spielberg can do his graduation in 50s, why do you think you are bound that you, oh, I have already grown up, I can't do. If you feel like that, you are going to miss out. Maya will tell you, no, you got to earn your living, you got to make money, you have to save, you have to do this, you have to do that. This is Maya's way of telling you. It is telling you, 7 children you have got, you see. Oh, and you got a wife, you got to do this and you got to do that. Who says there is something that can stop you? At that age, you may think, you know, age is a big problem for me. Who says there is a problem? You can become graduate at the age of 90 also. It doesn't make any difference. Do you think you have lost time? I mean, people have this, remember the last verse, he said, no, time. You keep on blaming me as time also. Time is a disruptor. It is only Maya which puts these things into the picture. Alright? And Maya is that gunas. Okay, Maya brings those gunas into the picture. Sattva, rajas and tamas. And because of that, you have distorted vision of reality. There is nothing real in that. Please don't worry even if you are graduating at the age of 70. You may think, what the hell, you know, why should I get graduated at 70? Who says you can't? Maybe you will do something by the time you are 80. Yesterday I saw one Chinese video, you know, there is one doctor who is 98 years old and he is still doing his, you know, service to mankind. He is using, alright. So, you think that is the age a person should be taking a rest and seat at the back? Oh, sorry, that's a mistaken point of view. Don't be in that state. There is no rest, by the way, okay? Don't say, I am retired. Okay? There is retired. You know what retire means? Go and tire yourself. One way, and you can retire yourself. Retreading, you know, the tires get retreaded again and you can use them once again. Yeah, you extend your life. Right? So don't give up on things. Alright? It is only Maya's creation. So don't even say that I can't do this and I can't do that. Even today, if you say, no, today, you know, it is so difficult to bend down. I have become so old. My back is hurting, this and that. Don't say that kind of words, okay? You can bend down. Like that. Alright. So, give yourself that much of credit that you can do anything. And Krishna is saying there is neither this nor that. What is it, this and that? There is neither bondage nor there is liberation. Alright. Neither, none of these things actually exist. Who is telling you they exist? You know, we are very great. Of course, mind only is telling you. And mind is a great person. He's an enactor for Maya. Okay? Maya, mind tells you are liberated or you are free or whatever. Or you'll say, you are bound. You have to do this. Many people have asked me this question. You see, I cannot get into spiritual because I am married, I have to look after my child, and when my child grows to an age when maybe he goes to college or something, at that time I will come. Do you think it is ever going to happen? They are bound by those words. Some people will say, I have to look after my family. I have to send money home. I have to do this. I have to do that. Keep on saying these words. Is it the truth? No, it is not the truth. You see, the moment you do this, you are making bondage with that person. It is like you keep on giving money to some person constantly. The person is expecting you to pay money. But suppose you are not giving, will that person not find ways and means of generating those funds? Of course. Then who is the one who is putting that person in bondage? You yourself are putting. And this is never understood by human beings. They say, you know, a husband and wife, you know, when people get married. Now let us say the husband is a good cook. And the person cooks. The wife will decide, you know, anyway, my husband is a good cook. Why do I need to cook? And the wife will not cook. The same happens in the reverse order also. The wife cooks till the end of his life. He doesn't even go and lift a thing in the kitchen. In India, the households are like this, where the husband has never entered the kitchen even to lift one plate. He will come and he will take food from there. And he will expect his wife to cook everything for him. Now, who has put that person in that state? The wife. She has made that person, that I should call him an idiot, okay? That person incapable. I don't have to cook, you see. Then what happens if she dies? There is all those apps, no? Nowadays I can order online. Wow! That's a very nice way of saying. And tomorrow all those apps are also going to stop working and then you will get into trouble. So, I hope this is called bondage and liberation. This aspect is never understood. Why do you put somebody else in bondage? Why do you make them succumb to you? Never do that. Never ever do that. And do not be under the impression that you are bound by that action. I have to pay every month, you know. Who said you have to pay every month? It is your mind which is telling you, you have to pay. Got it? I am bound by these things. There is no bondage like that. Please understand, there is no bondage in this world. And there is no liberation also, by the way. Person may say, no, I don't have anything to think of. I am free. What stupid that person is talking. What stupidity that person is talking. Nobody is free. Okay, I will guarantee you them like that and you will be dead. Okay, no freedom there. No fish in this ocean can say I am free. There is always a bigger fish. And the biggest fish will say I am free. Sorry, there are whalers also out there. So you got the point? So there is a whaler out there who is going to come after you. So this universe has been made like this. So Krishna says, it's the Maya which puts the gunas in place and the gunas will tell you whether it is bound or it is free. People are bound or free. And because of this reason, you are trapped. It is because of freedom or it is because of bondage. One of the things is trapping you. So don't get caught up in this kind of a rap anytime. Nowhere. Why? Because Krishna is giving his opinion. He says, there is neither freedom nor bondage. There is none of these things are there. They actually don't exist. No. No relationship can bind you. No relationship can bind you with absolutely anything. Neither with your car, your house, your relatives, your friends, your spouses, your companies, your objects in life, your clothes, nothing can bind you. You can just let it go and get out of this world. it does not really matter. You see, that is why there are these Jains, I think they are called Digambar Jains. Digambar Jains can walk naked anywhere. They are not bound by anything. They can take uposhan for many days, that is, they will not eat food also for many days. Does it matter? There it doesn't matter. They have reached that lofty state of being where body is not bondage. Body is not equal to bondage. Did you get the point? Body is the one which binds you. Right? Now, we'll move to verse 2. Chapter 6, verse 2 from the Uddhava Gita. Grief and infatuation, happiness and misery, as well as taking on a body are due to Maya. Just as a dream is a fiction of the mind, so transmigration is not a reality. We have been learning about transmigration, no? We are thinking about, oh, I will be born again, I have to suffer again, I have born again and suffer again. Isn't that what people think? Krishna is telling you something very, very sweetly over here. All these diversities that you see, grief and infatuation. There is grief on one side. Somebody is dead. Somebody is hurt. Somebody is sick. Dying. Whatever the case might be, there is grief which people go through. I am very upset because somebody died. I feel sad that this person doesn't exist. What are you talking about? There is infatuation on the other side. Again, I love my children. I love this toddler of mine. I love this one. I love that one. This one is good to me. These are the things, you know, the yo-yo of this side and that side. One day it is grief. One day it is, oh, happiness. All this. Happiness and misery. Both sides. As well as taking up of the body. You seem to have a body, isn't it? You have a body. I am a body, we say, no? My name is so and so. It's all because of Maya. The previous verse we said, Maya creates this illusion. So this illusion called body has been created by Maya. And please do not mix Maya with the Lord, okay? It is the potency of the Lord. Potency means what I'll tell you. You know, if I make a face like that, what is the expression that you are talking about? Some people will think, you know, look at him, he's very angry. Some people will say, that's a comedy show for you. Got the point? Those who know, they will say, oh, he's doing some comedy just now. You know those small pictures that we have to put at the beginning of a video? They're called thumbnails, no? Or thumbnails. Have you seen the thumbnails? They are just a stupid expression. Okay, somebody will... I want you. You know, I'm sure you have seen that thumbnail. It's like that. It is just an expression, but an expression can be comedy also. It's not that it is somebody is crying. For one person, it is tragedy. For the other person, it's comedy. So you understand these kind of things are appearing because of Maya. God is not involved in this. There is no such thing as God is involved. Maya is creating it. It is like a dream. It is like a dream. It is just pure fiction. Actually, it doesn't exist. It's a dream or a creation of the mind. Never get disturbed by it. Even in the worst case scenario, please do not bother your head about so many things that are happening. This is happening to me. What am I going to do? Don't worry, it's a creation of your own mind. It is not a reality at all. And because it is a creation of your mind, which is equal to the Maya in this world, it is your own mind which creates this yo-yo for you. The happiness is because of the mind, The sadness is because of the mind. The misery is because of the mind. The you know, infatuation is because of the mind. Whatever you say, please, all this is related to the mind. And it, mind is equal to Maya in this case. And what is Krishna saying? None of this actually exists. So we're going to stop over here. Next time when we open up, I will give you an idea about transmigration and why this somebody feels so much bothered by it. So we will stop over here and I'll see you all in the coming week. Take care. You have a very good day. Bye.